toxic warnings on all antidepressants and many other psychotropic drugs. This does not mean you should quit practicing psychopharmacology, but you must be aware and you must follow what are the warnings from the adverse effects. How this black box is written and from where it comes from. Lucky enough, psychiatrists have good chance of a black box warnings for psychoactive medications. It is just warnings before suddenness or severely injured patients. To my surprise, according to the Psychiatric News magazine, 12% of the psychiatrists never read the black box warnings. 50% might read the warnings sometimes, and the rest they read carefully and take into consideration. You can categorize yourself from which group. However, the economists and the physicians, when they studied, did these black box warnings and alarms influence the prescriptions among the psychiatrists? It did not influence the prescriptions. It did not minimize prescribing medications in certain issues. And the sales are the same before and after the black box warnings. The FDA black box warning, what do they mean for the consumer and what do they mean for the psychiatrist? I will start in a little bit details for the antipsychotics and then we will review the other medications in a moment. Safety concerns of atypical and non-psychotics, they have mortalities and cerebrovascular adverse events, they have risk of hyperglycemia and diabetes mellitus. All this research comes to the committee working on the black box FDA committee. The death with antipsychotics in elderly patients with behavioral disturbances, 15 out of 17 placebo-controlled studies showed numerical increase of mortality among elderly patients using antipsychotics. Specific cause of this death due to heart-related events, heart failure, sudden death, and infections. If we look at one or two of the considerable studies, like meta-analysis studies regarding comparative use of risperidone in elderly patients versus placebo, we found that about 13-fold increase of mortalities among the elderly patients. Also, the use of olanzapine in patients with dementia, about 15-fold increase in mortalities among elderly patients. Behavioral symptoms, usually 30-40% of persons with dementia, they have significant behavioral and psychiatric symptoms. And usually the family and the guardians, they come to the psychiatrist to solve the problems of high rates of functional impairment, disability, worse health outcomes, the physical injury, the increased rates of hospitalization, the change of behavior, the inverted sleep rhythm. What they will do, according to the studies, atypical antipsychotics, six controlled research control trials, the modest statistically significant effects, those drugs, they do help. But few adverse events happen on lower doses. Typical antipsychotics, minimal efficacy. The mood stabilizers, no efficacy. Anti-epileptic drugs, no efficacy. Cholinesterase inhibitors, minimal effect. Memantine and other anti-Alzheimer conflicting results. So the committee of the FDA black box warnings, they have regular meetings and they update their knowledge and they vote. Usually the committee is odd numbers, 11, 7, 9, and then they get voting what will be the coming warnings. Beyond the control, advancing age risk of doubles after the age of 55 years, male gender, African American, family history of diabetes, family history of stroke, transient ischemic attacks, and other medical risk factors. So now what the consumers need to know taking the medication, it will increase the risk of death, and it will increase the risk of cardiovascular adverse events. Don't take if it is poor outcome and functional impairment or increased likelihood of placement, limited alternatives, treatments. We will pass now by specific medications. What did the committee for the black box warnings stated? For the antipsychotics, the prototype of the Beers group is clozapine. Clozapine was an until now, maybe it is the best medication for resistant schizophrenics, suicidal schizophrenics. But the black box warning states that collapse, respiratory arrest, cardiac arrest during the initial treatment has occurred in patients who were being administered benzodiazepines or antipsychotic medication. And benzodiazepines now include the seizures, usually in high doses, and if there is positive family history of seizures, and if there is past history of seizures, and it is high risk when the patient is feverish. When the patient is feverish in the hospital or at home, in the family, they must have the information that they should stop the medication immediately. Clozapine also has a risk of myocarditis. A psychiatrist, clinical psychiatrist, should inquire about chest pain and should regularly check for the heart condition. Clozapine has a weird adverse events, which is acanthocytosis, which was the main reduction of the use of clozapine in resistant and suicidal schizophrenics. This repetitive seen, not frequently seen, but at least the commonest. It is not uncommon among patients using clozapine. So we have to, you have to get the total leukocytic count and the absolute neutrophils count this line, and in 4 weeks again. Olanzapine is the second prototype, it is the second molecule of the Beers group. It is a precaution stage co-administration of intramuscular clonazepam and intramuscular olanzapine for injection added to the somnolence observed with either drug alone. Concomitant use of diazepam or clonazepam with olanzapine has a great risk of hypoventilation and respiratory depression. Cotiapine, it is also from the Beers group, and it is modified molecule of clozapine and cotiapine. Also co-administration with clonazepam, there are case records of respiratory depression. For cotiapine, although cotiapine has not been classified as an antidepressant, but the FDA has required the risk of suicidality when used for depression. FDA has issued special warning for cotiapine XR in elderly dementia, confusion, and loss of memory. So keep the dose low as much as you can. The black box warning for risperidone, increased mortality risk with dementia related psychosis, reports of death due to heart failure, arrhythmia, and death, reports of increased mortality of risperidone with furosemide, LASIX, and should be avoided. It heightens and increases the risk of arrhythmia. This does not mean that haloperidol is an innocent molecule or an innocent medication. Haloperidol, the conventional antipsychotics, also they have, they do have the same adverse events in elderly. It is not approved for dementia-related psychosis. It is increased mortality and seizure risk like the typical antipsychotics. The recommendation how to reduce the overdose risk with super beans group or the beans atypicals. Because of the psychiatric patients have a higher respiratory mortality than the general population, monitor the patients, atypical, with these three atypicals as one might be prescribing benzodiazepines. Only from the patient while you are giving benzodiazepines. Play x-ray tests before you start the medication. Keep checking by the pulse oximeter what about the oxygen saturation. Combination therapy are here to stay. We have to use combination therapy, and so we should monitor the patient. Otherwise, we have the risk of confusion, delirium, arrhythmias, and others. Now, a brief look about antiepileptics. Valproic acid, which is very widely used by us for all the patients and different ages, young, adults, and old. We use it as mood stabilizers. Valproic acid has three cardinal adverse events: hepatotoxicity, teratogenicity, and pancreatitis. For hepatotoxicity, the hepatic failure resulting in fatalities has occurred in patients receiving valproic acid and its derivatives. Children under the age of 2 years old, it should be given with great caution, and we should follow and trace the liver functions before and after. These incidents usually have occurred during the first 6 months of use. Serious fatal hepatotoxicity are produced by non-specific symptoms such as malaise, weakness, lethargy, facial edema, anorexia, vomiting. So liver functions should be monitored. Valproic adverse events, pancreatitis, cases of life-threatening pancreatitis have been reported in both the children and adults receiving Valproic. Patients and guardians should be warned that abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, and or anorexia can be symptoms of pancreatitis and may require prompt medical evaluation. Pancreatitis is diagnosed by CT scan abdomen. Valproic teratogenicity, such as neural tubal defects with the patients, the bipolar patients, going on and using valproic, and she's asking you, she is pregnant, what would be your decision? She will continue or she has to quit? I think she has to quit. We have to avoid during pregnancy. It is not uncommon to have cases like spinal bifida with the childbirth for the mothers using Depakine. The patient information leaflet describing the teratogenetic potential of valproic is available for the patients. So the patient is checking after you also. Carbamazepine, Decretol, serious dermatologic side effects, Steven Johnson and aplastic anemia, Steven Johnson syndrome and rash, agranulocytosis, suicidal behavior, and ideations. Topiramate, Topamax, oligohydrosis, malignant rash. He should avoid the sun. Otherwise, he has a risk of heat stroke, hyperthermia. He can be feverish. Children and vaguely defined elderly are especially susceptible to these, which often happen together, kidney stones and others. Topiramate, discontinue if there is acute myopia. Discontinue if there is angle closure to glaucoma. If there is dilated pupils, redness of the eye, and a cloudy cornea. Just look at the eye the patient uses topiramate. Black box warning for lamotrigine, serious skin rashes. The incidence is 1 in 1,000 for Steven Johnson syndrome. Sometimes it's fatal. Suggestions: co-administration of lamictal and valproic should be avoided. Exceeding recommended initial dose should be avoided. Just keep an eye and look at the patient's face when she comes or when he comes next and revisit using the lamictal. It happens usually in the first 8 weeks of administration. The antidepressants and the SSRIs and the suicidal intentions and the suicidal risk. Suicide warning for sertraline, paroxysteine, and all the SSRIs molecules. Some claim that Robin Williams' suicide was likely caused by antidepressants and not caused by that depression itself. Although Robin Williams was an alcoholic, he was a drug user, and he was under medication for a long time, and he was not under medication during the time of suicide. SSRIs has a great risk of suicide, an increase of suicidal thoughts. The story behind that, when the fluoxetine was introduced, Prozac was introduced in the beginning, it was claimed that it increases the alleviates immediately the psychomotor retardation of the patients and encourages the patient who has a suicidal thought. But we have also homicidal acts. We have shooting in schools for teens and youngsters. We have, what about the teen suicide? This picture for a man committed suicide day before yesterday in Cairo, and he hanged himself. Two reports until now reported. One said that it is because of unemployment. The other said no, he was under medication and he was following a psychiatrist. Serotonin syndrome, confusion, agitation, dilated pupils, headache, hyperperfusis, you should be taken into consideration. In 2006, the FDA warned healthcare providers to be vigilant about the antidepressants combination with antidepressant drug triptan medications because it induces the serotonin syndrome. Antidepressants with a persistent pulmonary hypertension in newborn, we should avoid antidepressants SSRI during pregnancy. Maybe the safest is sertraline. Single reports about it with the pregnancy. Some reports say that it is safer to use it after the 4 months of pregnancy. Methylphenidate has a risk of drug dependence, emotional instability, chronic abuse of market tolerance, and psychological dependence. Frank psychotic episodes can occur, especially with parenteral abuse. Also, Stratera has the risk of hypertension, tachycardia, structural cardiac abnormalities. Alprazolam, Xanax, it has a risk not for use in untreated open-angle glaucoma. Reevaluate the medicine and change the dose gradually, directed by your patients to check his eye. Also, diazepam, Valium, not to use in untreated open-angle glaucoma and not to use in shock, in coma, in acute alcohol intoxication, even in obstetric conditions and neurotoxic infections should be avoided. Last, zolpidem. It has a complex related sleep behavior, sleep talking, sleep walking, and sometimes bizarre behavior, especially when it is used for the first time in elderly. Keep the dose low and keep an eye on the patient on medication for the first few days. Then, if something like this happens, discontinue the medication. The conclusion. We are in a challenges in our clinical settings. We have the chronic pain patient, sometimes nothing works. And we are working under pressure with this patient. So you are pressed to prescribe and over-prescribe. Take the consent and tell the patient you are at risk. The patient who knows too much, the patient who comes with his laptop, or with his tablet, or with his iPad, and they check every word you say, and they check after every prescription you write, and immediately he will tell you how you prescribe this medicine if it has a black box warning. What are you going to do with the angry patient? Discover in the leaflet that this patient, that this drug has a black box warning. It is a challenge for us, the patient for whom nothing works, don't over-prescribe. To conclude in a word, FDA black box warnings should be gone, taken into consideration and it changes our prescription behavior. One should follow and replace the updates in FDA and black box warnings and the shared experiences. When necessary, throw light to the agents, guardians, and guide them. You can subscribe in blackboxwarningprescription.com, and it is about for 60 bucks a year. Every and all the information comes to you about all the prescriptions and what you should do. And thank you very much.
لو ما استعملوش انسجه
This exactly was the answer of so several articles rejecting the warnings of the FDA, exactly as you said.
And again, I have a chance to close to our kind guest speaker of the week. I have a long story and long occasions. We will talk again about a very interesting topic related to our modern shift. We will talk about the neural stem cell in the brain and the relevance for our psychiatric topic. Thank you and welcome here.